a slightly harder example in your substitution. Say you have square root of 5x minus 2 over 2dx. Now, in order to be able to check whether our answer is right or wrong, let me try to solve this integral without using u substitution, and preferably I don't want you to write the things that I'm writing with green. Okay. So here's what I would do if I want to avoid having to do u substitution, because it's always faster if you can avoid doing all that u substitution work. Okay. So I will do this. I will write it as like 5x over 2 minus 1, because 5x divided by 2 is 5x over 2, or even I would say 5 over 2 times x minus 2 over 2, that's 1. And then square root can be written as 1 half. So that's what I can do it to. And I know how to integrate something that has one half on top. Oh, the thing is, 5 over 2x minus 1 is nested inside, so I better have the artifact of the chain rule if I want to undo this chain rule. If I want to consider this thing inside as like a u, I better have the artifact of the chain rule. So what kind of artifact do I need? I need what outside?
5 over
2. So to create 5 over 2, I would put 2 over 5 outside and put 5 over 2, 5 over 2x minus 1 to the 1 half power dx. And now, because the derivative of this is that, I can just regard this as like a u to the 1 half power with this is going to go away when you undo the chain rule. So let's see what that gives us. That's like 2/5 times, if you add 1 to the exponent, that's 5 over 2x minus 1 to 3/2, and you have to put the reciprocal in front. This 5 over 2 went away because that's the artifact of the chain rule. And finally, there will be 4 over 15, 5 over 2x minus 1, 3 over 2. That will be the quick way of finding the answer. And let's write down the results somewhere here so we can make sure that our u substitution gave us the same answer. Now this green thing was a little technical, so if you didn't fully understand what I was doing, that's fine too. In fact, probably if you saw this question on the exam, it's better to use u substitution. It's easier to make more errors if you do it like this. Okay. So let's do it the u substitution way. The u substitution way actually has two different ways. I'm going to show you the first one, and then actually the second one will be more interesting. So the first one is kind of natural. You just say u equals to 5x minus 2 over 2. So that du is equal to 5x minus 2 over 2 prime dx. What's the derivative of 5x?
5.
5, right? What's the derivative of negative 2?
Zero.
Zero. And this 2 in the denominator can be thought as 1 half times the entire thing. So it's really like a constant multiple. So you can bring the 1 half outside, and you're only differentiating 5x minus 2, which just gives you 5, and times 1 half will give you 5 over 2. So you get this relationship. Du is 5 over 2 dx. And then you multiply 2 both sides. You multiply by 2 over 5 both sides, so you solve for dx. So dx is 2 over 5 times du, or you can say it's the reciprocal. Now we have everything we need. We have this and that. So this integral now becomes integration of u, and then times 2/5 of du. Dx now became 2/5 du, and u became 5x minus minus 2 over 2 became just u. Then the integral is 2 over 5 integration of u to the 1 half power du. Add 1 to the exponent, which is 3 over 2. Put the reciprocal in front, which is 2 thirds, 2 over 5. So that's 4 over 15 u to the 3 over 2 plus c. And the problem with u substitution is many times people get overly excited that they found some result, they stop right here and get points off. Right? It'll be sad, right, if you stop here. What do you have to do after this? You have to do 4 over 15, 5x minus 2 over 2, so 3 over 2 power plus c, which is exactly same as this result we had. I want you to see the second method, because often what happens is that when you see a square root, things get easier if you take the entire square root as u, especially if the thing inside is just x. If there's x squared, then probably that's not a good idea. It could fail, but it may or may not work, but especially when you just have x, you'll see that taking u as the entire thing is sometimes helpful. For this method, it may not be that much better, but there are cases, I'm going to show you another example later, which is a lot better if you do it this way. Okay? Alright, so you take the entire thing as u. The trouble with having this entire thing as u is that when you try to differentiate it, you have to use the chain rule. It's really painful. So instead of doing it that way, if you have u equal to something complicated, a nice thing you can do is to solve for x before you differentiate. Okay? So we're going to square both sides. Multiply by 2. Add 2, divide by 5. So now you have this result that x is equal to 2u squared plus 2 over 5. But that's not what we want. We want actually dx. So what do? Dx is, you differentiate this, right? What do you get if you differentiate?
4u
over
5,
and then times d
u,
right? To say dx is equal to the derivative of this times du, so you differentiate this, which gives you 4u over 5. See, 2u squared differentiates to 4u, and 2 differentiates to 0. This 5 in the denominator is just the constant multiple, so that's what you get, okay? All right, so we have this, and then we go back and rewrite the integral. This time, it's not square root of u, the entire thing is u. The entire thing is u. And then you have dx equals to 4u over 5 du. We can bring the 4 over 5 outside because that's a constant multiple, and u times u is u squared du. And what's the integral of u squared? U cubed, right?
Yeah.
Add 1 to the exponent, you put the reciprocal in front, so you have to multiply 1 third to this, which is 4 over 15, plus c, and then you have to go back and plug that in, so that gives you 4 over 15 times, actually, square root of 5x minus 2 over 2 cubed plus c. And the same thing as this one, only difference is here the square root is written as half power. So these are exactly the same answer.